Pemirsa Kabari, sekarang saya sedang berada di Konsulat Jenderal Republik Indonesia di Los Angeles, California, di mana sekarang sedang ada Food Workshop dan Entrepreneurial Seminar yang diselenggarakan oleh Indonesian Trade Promotion Center. Nah, saya mau meliput nih acaranya bagaimana. Yuk, saksikan terus liputannya.
A workshop, Q&A session, and most excitingly, a food tasting and demo by Jafar.
And we are very lucky that one of the proponents or even the igniter of this movement is here today with us, Ibu Mari Pangestu. And as I say, as a guy who loves food, of course I thank everybody who has been making efforts to come here. And of course this will not be a one-off event, because a promotion of culinary, Indonesian culinary, will be a continuous effort that this consulate is going to do. And of course, we, as always, we need engagements and participation from the Indonesian community, because without that, consulate cannot do anything. So thank you very much, and I expect a good afternoon with not only presentation but also workshop and demonstration, and after that, of course, eating the food. So welcome and thank you very much.
Basically, we decided that, okay, when you ask somebody, what is Indonesian food? If you ask somebody from Padang, they will say nasi Padang, right? If you ask somebody from Surabaya, they will say rawon. If you talk to somebody from Manado, they will say ikan ikarika, rica-rica, yeah, and so on. So there, when you ask somebody Indonesian food, I think the only answer that you maybe can get consistently is nasi goreng, maybe rendang. Yeah? Even rendang, is it Malaysian, is it Indonesian? Yeah. So we lack the understanding about what is Indonesian food. So we started on this journey by saying, okay, we cannot have too many food, because Indonesia is so diverse that there's so many food. In each province have different food. Yeah. So we said, okay, we need to agree what is Indonesian food and what we want to promote, and we cannot promote too many. So I just pick a number. I said, I don't want 100. I don't want 10. I want somewhere in between. You guys choose. So we collected all the different ministries involved, as well as the chef association, everybody involved in food, including the people who are producing the spices and so on. And Garuda was also part of the group. I locked them up for 6 months. I said, you come up with what I would say is the 30 iconic culinary dishes in Indonesia. And in the end, we did come up, because this is, I think, part of the Thai success story. When you say Thai food, people will say pad Thai, green curry. It's standardized, yeah? So you have to standardize it. So first pick it, and then second, standardize the recipe so that people get familiar to the taste, and then promote it in a standardized way. So we hope that that's already a good beginning for the supply of the spices. Thank you.
They recommend me to do more roadshows along the farmers across Indonesia, and it opens my eyes. The first day I made the roadshow, the farmers was asking me whether I want to go to the rice field with him in the morning. 5 o'clock in the morning, he knocked on the door and he said, have you done your prayers? Yes, I did. Okay, let's go. Do you want to go to the rice field? Yes, I would like. And then he was asking, can you take off your shoes? I was like, why do I have to take off my shoes? No, that's part of your, so that you don't put a gap between you and the plants and the soil. That's part of the spiritualism that we believe. So I was like, okay, so I took off my shoes. And then he gave me another question. Are you in a good mood? I said, why? No, if you're not in a good mood, I would rather not to have you in my rice fields, because you will upset my rice plants. And I said, like, okay. So it was amazing because we went from West Java up to Bali and also in the eastern part of Indonesia. Everybody speaking the same thing. And then we talk about the salts, we talk about the spices, we talk about so many things. And I said, like, this is what Indonesia have, which other countries doesn't have. But who will introduce them? So we decided to work with the farmers too, so that they can have a market guarantee to keep continuing growing that kind of indigenous plants. And we give them the guarantee to purchase, and they can decide that whatever the price they want. So we started the company in 2009 in operation, and we put the story to it. So every packaging that we have, we put the stories. Whenever we have the space to do so, we put the faces of the farmers, you know, and then, you know, we put the whole posters and marketing system. Because for us, it's not about selling the products. It's about keeping alive the biodiversity. It's about keeping alive the spiritualism that goes with it. It's about the story behind the product, and it's about the producers behind the product. And apparently, we have more success in Europe rather than Indonesia. Actually, in Indonesia, we do more with the different colors. This one is using the sejang or asadin wood, and it has the function of blocking the carbohydrates. Isn't it perfect? A lot of people are avoiding to eat rice because of the carbohydrates content to it. But this asadin wood is basically helping to block that.